Hi students, welcome to Order School e-learning classes. Our before class, 9th class social studies, first chapter, our earth, session 1 completed. This session 1 completed topics is, what is universe, how is universe formed, what is heliocentric theory? What is geocentric theory? What is Big Bang theory? What is Earth as a planetary body? What is rotation? What is revolution? We learn. Today, session 2 of our earth. This session 2 topic is the evolution of the earth. Evolution of the earth. The scientists are still debating how earth was formed. Most of the scientists, the views is the earth was began 4.5 billion years ago. The scientists view as per earth was began 4.5 billion years ago. The earth has reached its position through several phases. The earth has present position through several phases. At that time, the earth was very hot, was constantly a bombarded massive rocks with other materials from the space. At that time, the earth was a molten stage. Molten stage means liquid form. At that time, the earth was grow at that process. Yeah, it is a ball of swirling dust and clouds and passes through the molten stage. It passes through the molten stage. At that time, the earth was hot. If you boil a thick soup, do you know making soup? If you boil thick soup, many substances mixed with. What you notice? The heavier particles tend to go down. The lighter particles come to the top. As like the earth is very hot, and the time in molten stage means liquid form. The heavier particles tend to go and reach the bottom of the earth. The heavier particles form a layer of core. The heavier particles tend to go down, form a layer of core. The lighter particles come to the top of the earth, form of a molten crust. Did you notice, children? Okay, next, the outer crust wrinkle forming after continuing as earth interior continues cooling. The outer crust wrinkle forming ridges and the basins. The wrinkles and basins. Wrinkles mean ridges. Ridges mean mountains. wrinkled ridges mean mountains and forming low lying basins. Low lying basins mean oceans. After we appear in atmosphere developed on the earth, the atmosphere of the earth consists of different kinds of gases including water vapor. Not only water vapor but also oxygen, nitrogen and carbon dioxide. So many gases mixed in our atmosphere. What is our breath of life? The breath of life gas is oxygen. For perhaps the long span of the Earth's history, the planet remained as lifeless and barren. The planet remained as lifeless and barren. After the life appeared in first time in the ocean. The life appeared in first in ocean, that is a single cellular organism. After two cellular organisms was developed, then life appeared, evolved in diverse plants, animals and larva, flagellata, Homopithecus, Ramapithecus, Homo erectus and Neanderthal men and Homo sapien. The evolution of man was started on the earth. This is the evolution of the earth. Let me repeat it again. The evolution of the earth. The scientists are still debating how Earth was formed. Most of the scientists come to one view. The Earth was began 4.5 billion years ago. The Earth was began 4.5 billion years ago. The Earth has reached its present position through several phases. The Earth was a ball of swirling dust and clouds and passes through the molten stage. That time Earth was grow. Earth was so hot and molten stage. Molten means liquid form. The heavier particles tend to go down. The lighter particles come to the top. The heavier particles come to go to down and reach the bottom of the earth. That is called core. The lighter particles come to the top. That is called crust. Okay children, the outer crust wrinkled, forming ridges and basins. The outer crust forming wrinkles and basins. Wrinkled ridges, ridges mean mountains, basins mean oceans. After some time, the atmosphere was appeared. The atmosphere consists of different gases, including in water vapor. Breath of life is oxygen. And a long span of Earth's history, barren and lifeless once upon a time. After, then life appeared in first in ocean, that is single cellular organism. Single cellular organism after developed two cellular organisms. After larva, flagellata, Neanderthal man, Homo sapien, these are evolution of the man also evolved. This is the evolution of the earth. Okay children, now the internal structure of the earth. The internal structure of the earth. Let us look at the internal structure of earth. Where we live in? We are living on top of the earth. The going inside is some kilometers only. Why? Because so many we digging inside of the air mines, the temperature will very high. The radius of the earth, radius Radius mean the distance between top of the earth and the center of the earth. The radius mean the distance between top of the earth and the center of the earth. The earth radius is 6,000 kilometers. 6,000 kilometers, the earth's radius. Okay children, scientific investigating analysis of the data from an understanding internal structure of the earth. The internal structure of the earth broadly divided into three layers. The internal structure broadly divided into three layers. The first one, crust. The second one, mantle. The third one, core. The internal structure broadly divided into three layers. The first one, crust. The second one, mantle. The third one, core. Here you see, this is the three layers. The first layer, crust. This is the second layer, mantle. The third layer is outer core. This one is inner core. Now let us discuss crust. The topmost layer of the earth is called crust. The topmost layer of the earth is called crust. This depth to 30 kilometers to 100 kilometers depth. The depth crust is 30 kilometers to 100 kilometers. In the crust, a different types of massive rocks is there. And pebble sediments and the massive rocks is there. In our Earth's interior part of the first layer, crust. The second one, mantle. The mantle depth up to 100 kilometers to 2900 kilometers. Mantle depth up to 100 kilometers to 2900 kilometers. Here, the chemical components of the silicates is there. Some silicates float on the mantle in internal structure of the earth. Next, the third layer is core. The third layer divided into two layers. This is the outer layer. This is the inner layer. The outer layer depth is 2900 to 5100. This is the outer layer distance mean depth. In the internal structure of the earth, depth in core is, especially in outer core, 2900 to 5100. The inner core depth is 5100 to 6376 kilometers. The inner core depth is 5100 to 6376 kilometers depth. The total core depth is 2900 to 6376 kilometers. This is the internal structure of the earth. In the core part is some mineral resource and chemical components is there. The chemical composition of the outer core, sima. Sima means silica and magnesium. The chemical components of the silica and magnesium is there. And inner core, Cr, silica and aluminium. And also nickel, iron, some mineral resources is there in core. This is the internal structure of the earth. Our earth is still active. Our earth is still very active. The changes in his position always still changed being in earthquakes, volcanoes, earth subduction, rise of the mountains due to process happening deep down the earth. This is the internal structure of the earth. Are you understood, children? After internal structure of the earth, now we discuss about the movements of the earth's crust. The movements of the earth's crust. The shape of the positions of the continents. The shape of the positions of the continents. How many continents is there? There are 7 continents. Asia, Europe, North America, South America, Africa, Antarctica, Australia, and Africa. These are 7 continents. And present how many oceans is there? The oceans is 5. Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Antarctic Ocean. These are present continents and the oceans. But once the continents is, however, when you look at the world earth, these continents have, look at the world earth, the continents have collided and moved. Okay, children? And the mountains have risen and have been raised to the ground. And the ocean have formed and dried up. And valleys have been curved. Our earth was an eventful history. Our earth have eventful history. On the 20th century, the German meteorologist, the German meteorologist and the geologist Alfred Wegener. What's the geographer name? Alfred Wegener. The Alfred Wegener introduced in continental drift theory. Continental drift theory. The present continents and oceans and based on the continental drift theory. Who introduced the continental drift theory? The continental drift theory is introduced by a German meteorologist and geologist, Alfred Wegener, introduced in continental drift theory. Once upon a time, the whole continents, present 7 continents is there. That one, once upon a time, all are single continent, single cosmic, single supercontinent. The single supercontinent mean 220 million years ago there was a supercontinent. 220 million years ago there was a supercontinent. That supercontinent name is Pangaea. That supercontinent name is Pangaea. Pangaea is the Greek word. That means whole land. Whole land. The Pangaea is the Greek word. Pangaea means one of the supercontinent. Once upon a time, there is no divisions, there is no variations of continents and oceans. There is no divisions and no variations of the continents and the oceans. At that time, the earth was whole one land. That one land is called supercontinent. The supercontinent name is Pangaea. The Pangaea word is derived from the Greek word. The Pangaea mean whole land. Here, one picture is there. 220 years ago, this is our supercontinent, Pangaea. As per our continental drift theory, you see in second picture. In second picture, one pink line is here. That pink line is dividing the continents is two parts. The Pangaea break up into two parts. The pink line is called one of the sea, that is called Tethys Sea. The Tethys Sea separated the Pangaea two parts. The two parts is called Laurasia land and the Gondwana land. One of the Laurasia land and the Gondwana land. As per the Mesozoic era, the Pangaea divided into two parts. The first one, Laurasia or Angara land. The second one, Gondwana land. The first one, Laurasia and Angara land. The second one, Gondwana land. The Laurasia Angara land consists of the Laurasia. See, here 220 million years ago, picture is here. The picture divided into Pangaea. The top of the one part and bottom of the one part. The top of the part is called Laurasia or Angara land. The bottom of the place is called Gondwana land. The Laurasia land consists of North America, Greenland, Eurasia. Eurasia means Russia. Eurasia and north of Indian subcontinent. These are included in Laurasia and Angara land. The second one, Gondwana land. The Gondwana land consists of, this is the Gondwana land. The Gondwana land consists of South America, Africa, Madagascar, India, Arabia, Malaysia, East Indies, Australia, and Antarctica. These are including in Gondwana land. As per our continental drift theory. Now, it millions of years for the continents reach the present shape and positions of the globe. It millions of years for the continents and the oceans, the present shape and the positions on the globe. As per, in the present positions is here, continents and oceans, the basis of the continental drift theory. That is the moments of the earth's crust. Let me repeat it again once. On the 20th century, a German meteorologist and the geologist, the named Alfred Wegener, proposed in continental drift theory. Once upon a time, these continents are together a single supercontinent. There is no division of continents, there is no division of oceans. At that time, that is called one single supercontinent. That single supercontinent is called Pangaea. The Pangaea is the Greek word derived from Greek. Our English word means Pangaea, mean whole land. As per the Mesozoic era, the Pangaea divided into two parts. The first one, Laurasia or Angara land. The second one, Gondwana land. The Angara land and the Gondwana land is separated by Tethys Sea. After it millions of years for the continents and the oceans on the globe as per the continental drift theory. This is the moments of the Earth's crust. Okay, students. The assignment based on 9th class social studies, chapter 1, session 2. The assignment given 4 questions is here. The first one, describe the theory of continental drift. Explain. Describe the theory of continental drift. Explain. The second question is, describe the process of evolution of the earth. Describe the process of evolution of the earth. The third question is, write about internal structure of the earth. Write about internal structure of the earth. The fourth question is, draw the picture of the interior of the earth. Draw the picture of the interior of the earth.